Bible says how I can raise up ordinary men, turning them to become supernatural beings, financial apostles, making life better, bringing people from the dungeon of sin, bringing them into the faith, planting their feet, and rising them.
Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost!
Mark chapter 6, verse 4. Pick your Bible while we stand for the reading. Mark chapter 6, verse 4. We are going to read it chorously. Are we there? But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is without honor, but in his own country, and among his own kin, and among his own house. We're going to read it chorously. Want to go? But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is without honor, but in his own country, among his own kin, and in his own house. Let's read it one more time before we have a seat. One, two, go. Jesus said unto them, a prophet is without honor, but in his own country, and among his own kin, and in his own what? House. Sit down with your enemy's head. That scripture is pregnant. But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is without honor. There are three things there. In his own country, in his own kindred, which is extended family, and in his own house, the nuclear family. So it simply means that Jesus understand what he was saying. Let's go continue in verse 5. And he could there do no mighty work, save that he laid his hand upon a few sick folk and healed them. Do you see that? So he could not do mighty works. He did in so many other places, but in his own kindred, in his own town where he came out from, he could not do mighty works. He just laid hands on few people. Few, look at it there. He laid hands on few sick folk and healed them. So it simply means the power was present to heal them, but because they don't understand what it takes to honor, so he couldn't do mighty works. I want to share with us on what I titled the spirit of honor. Give Jesus a clap of him. The spirit of honor. The spirit of honor. The spirit of honor. Jesus, if it was maybe Peter said that, I would say maybe Peter does not understand the word well, but this was the word talking himself. This was Jesus talking himself, that a prophet is without honor. Without honor. That means honor is very essential to activate miracles. Honor is very essential to activate miracles. Now, in the next verse, we saw that because he was not honored, he could not do mighty works. It's so bad for a prophet to go out of his kindred, his country, and perform mighty miracles outside, but come around his own people that needed the oil, most importantly, but cannot do mighty works and lay hands on few of them. Now, you have to understand why he healed few of them was to make us to understand that the anointing was present and resident in him to do mighty work, but because they could not honor him, he healed few of them. The greatest barrier, barricade, power that can limit the oil and the grace of a man of God is when God has given him unction and the people dishonor him. I have discovered that honor is a spirit. There is what I call the spirit of honor. I'm not talking about high service honor, hypocritical honor. I'm talking about honor as being part of you as a baptism. So Jesus could not do mighty work because he was not honored by his people. So it is possible to have a first class prophet in your family and never benefit from his oil. It is possible to have a first class prophet, an anointed man of God, and never benefit from the oil. And others can travel from all over the world and get that same oil that you don't honor. You must understand that the spirit of honor activates miracle. The spirit of honor brings mighty outpour of supernatural heartbreak of the miraculous. The spirit of honor makes the Messiah to be seen evidently around your life. Honor. No matter how anointed a man of God is, when you don't honor the oil, prophecy becomes a mere wind blowing around you. The greatest havoc is to be around a great oil and think you know him. That was why Mary, blessed are you among women. Why? Mary knew that Jesus came out of her bowel, but yet honored him. He said in the first miracle he performed in Cana, he said, whatever he said to you, do it. She honored her son. That was why she is relevant. I don't care why many people don't love, they honor Mary. It doesn't matter. But listen to me. Mary showed Jesus honor. That's why her name cannot be erased in history. When you honor a highly anointed man, you will be honored in life. We never saw Joseph comment about his son that way. But we saw Mary following Jesus doggedly. I might have carried you in my womb, but I'm not familiar with the oil upon your life, because I understand that there is your divine nature and your human nature. For your divine nature, I salute you. We are not classmates, because I understand that what you carry is from above. I must have given birth to you, but you are greater than me. The greatest havoc is to be around a man of God and think you know him, because you know him by name, because you have sat down with him. And that's why check church, 90% of the people that don't get miracle are around the man of God. They are close. They can even tell you, we just finished talking with him. Do you know why? There is no spirit of honor. When he talks, others will carry it serious. But when they hear it, they hold it with levity. Next week, Sunday, we are fasting. We are bringing the oil. They will not bring oil, because they think they know him. You must understand that when you don't honor the oil, you see disgrace.
Stay tuned, the man of God will be back. Champions Television, raising a generation of champions. Worship with us at Champions Royal Assembly and experience a life transforming service. In Champions, we are happy people. In Champions, we are word based people. In Champions, we are people of praise. And we are a prayer generation. Visit us at our international headquarters at number 1 Ikolaba Street behind Deeper Life Biazin, Kubwa, Abuja, Nigeria. Or contact us on the following numbers +234-814-943-9447 or +234-807-213-3004. You can visit our website at www.championsroyalassembly.com. Come and experience power.
Whether the man of God is highly anointed and dead body are rising up, you can't get a miracle where you don't honor him. Jesus purposely did not perform mighty miracle in his own town. Why? Because you can't look down on the oil and get the oil. Look at John chapter 7, verse 15. Let me show you how they treated the oil. He said, "And the Jews marveled and saying, I know where this man. How knoweth this man letters, having never learned?" Simply meaning he never schooled. He never went to any university. So how did he know letters? How did he know how to read? Meaning not words. They were even embarrassing Jesus that the man did not know ABCD. It was not words. It was letters. Say, did this man know letters? Did he know A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H? Did he know it? So, he never schooled. How did he know these things he said? There are some of you that you are specialists to dig the foundation of a man of God. Even when he has left that level, you think he's still there. You think he's still in secondarian. I never know he has left the level. Because you are special. So you look at it. That was how they were using to judge Jesus. Yet this guy never went to primary school. That means he never went to any secondary school. That was how they knew his background and his biography. They said, this man no letters. It was the highest level of insult to the fountain of knowledge. The only wisest God. He's called Hominiscience. Hominiscience. The God that can count the numbers of the sand in the sea. The God that can look at the fish and give you the aggregate mathematical formula of the aquatic animals within a second. And they were asking that, does this man know letters? When people dishonor the oil, they can root out anything. This way, Pharisees, PhD holders, pull him down. Knowledge without result. No result. The boy at the age of 12 opened the Bible, spoke in the temple. Teachers, PhD holders, theologians, they were amazed at the manner of wisdom. Wisdom is the elder brother to knowledge. Knowledge is acquired from any university, but wisdom is from above. A man can have PhD in all kind of areas in life, but yet is not wise. Still foolish. When he talks, you don't see wisdom in his mouth. He can't even settle misunderstanding between his children because there are no wisdom. Some people are old, but yet they are elderly men trapped with a kid heart. Children have. They can't settle misunderstanding. Because maturity has got nothing to do with gray hair. It got nothing to do with age. It is the construction of the heart. Church is quiet. Are you amazed that they even told Jesus that he was not schooled? That's why when God wants to rise anything, he uses the foolish things of this earth to confirm the wisdom of the wise. He will use the most insignificant person and he arise a professor. Because when you think you are intelligent, God comes from an angle where you least expect to speak to you. And that's why you must understand the power of honor. The power of honor. The power of honor. The power of honor. Malachi chapter 1 verse 5. Let's go there. Are we there? He said, and your eyes shall see. And ye shall say that the Lord will be magnified from all the borders of Israel. Verse 6. A son honoreth his father, and a servant his master. If I then be your father, where is my honor? If I then be your master, where is my fear? Saith the Lord of hosts, unto you, O priest, that despise my name, and ye say, wherein have we despised thee? Ye offer polluted bread upon my altar, and say, wherein have we polluted thee? In that ye say, the table of the Lord is contemptible. Look at it. If you fear your master, you fear your father, God asks you, where is my fear? You enter the church and you are answering phone call in the presence of I am that I am. Where is my honor? That's the greatest problem we have in the Pentecostal church. We don't understand what it means to honor God. A man of God is preaching and you are busy sending texts. You don't understand what it takes to honor God. Look at a Muslim driver going on the highway and carrying a teen passenger. When it is the hour of prayer, he parks the car. No matter the abuses you say, he does his abomination. He lies. He crosses his leg, insulting from mounting the kingdom come. He must make that prayer. But look at us. We don't know what it takes to honor God, and much more honoring our prophets. No honor. No honor. How do you come to church? Praise time, you are walking up and down. Do you honor God? No, that means you don't even know that there is a God that's seated in the heaven and across the circumference of the earth. And he stays in the seat and he looks down to the earth and look at his people praising him, and he inhabits the praise of his people. And in the presence of God, you are misbehaving, and God look at you and say, if I am your father, where is my honor? If I am your master, where is the fear that you have for me? No fear. No fear. We don't understand this. When you go to Orthodox church, they enter quietly and behave quietly and stay quietly. They have been indoctrinated to understand that once they enter church, God is there. It is only in the Pentecost that we have rascalities. Rascality without the reference of God. Ladies and gentlemen, what is honor? Honor means respect. Reference to higher authority. Respect. Anybody that is estimable should be given honor. Where is my respect? Where is my fear? God is asking you. Is this how you honor me? You honor me by receiving phone call in my presence. You honor me that I am talking to you. You go out and answer call and return back and say, hey, God, where did you stop? Let us continue. No fear. Let me tell you how I know that God can answer you is your degree of fear for the unseen God. Respect. How can you be in the church? Service is going on. You are gossiping in the church. It's a shame. That shows the level of low level of wisdom that you have. God is watching you. You are talking about somebody in his own house. And you say you have fear. No wonder your prayers cannot be answered. It's not a cause. God has looked at you and said, you don't have my fear. You don't honor me. How can I answer a very disrespectful human being like you? High level of disrespect. We don't honor God. How can you come to service and you are arguing and fighting in the church?
Exactly, sir.
That's why some people don't understand spiritual protocols. Some miracles can never happen. How do you fight the ambassador of God and expect God to answer you? Any attempt to disrespect the ambassador of America here in Nigeria is an insult to America. They can't take it lightly because it's an embodiment of USA represented and instituted here in Nigeria. And that's why he must be treated with respect. Look at what happened in Libya. When the ambassador or some few Americans were tossed, the whole CNN had to take it. Do you know why? They represent a powerful country in the continent. How much more we that are sent by God, we represent the Federal Republic of Heaven, and you are insulting us. That's why angels have drawn sword. That's why some people are about to die because of the way they run their mouth and nose when they are talking about God's servants. The spirit of honor. Your prophet is not your classmate. It's not your age mate. He's sent by God to your life as a messenger with a message to massage failure out of your life. Every attempt to run him down, you are running God down. That's why I can never talk about any man of God. Why? Because I understand they represent heaven. No honor. The spirit of honor. Honor. Where is my fear? Where is my honor? If you said you honor me, show me. I want to see the honor. Show me. That's what God is saying. Show me the honor. Church is quiet. Somebody shout fire. There's a spirit that enables us to operate in honor, and it's called the spirit of honor. God has designed us for honor. But for you to attract honor, you must know how to show honor. Maga, Zaga, shout fire 3 times. So, what do I honor? That's the question. What do I honor? Number one, you honor God. You honor God. You honor God. That's what you saw there in Malachi chapter 1, verse 6. God was demanding for his honor. How do you come to church and praise and worship? You are not there. I've seen pastors, when it is time for praise and worship, they are in the office. They are too big. When it is now time for message, protocols will carry their Bible. They will not be coming into the church. Then I ask myself, Is that how to honor God? Are you bigger than God that you are not here in praise and worship? Then you come after praise and worship. That is a barbaric way to serve God. As a pastor, you must be there to show that you are under God, His authority, and reference Him. When a pastor is absent in praise and worship, I now know that he does not have reverence for God, that he feels his Alpha and Omega. Because what makes the Sunday service a worship service is praise and worship. Now, when you are not there for praise and worship, what have you come to do? Sit. Praise and worship is going on. Look at your attitude. You are looking at people that are dancing. So why are they dancing like this? What is your business? Are they dancing unto you? Are you the one? The person is leading praise. You are saying, out of key, out of point. How dare you judge the praise and worship? It belongs to God. He inhabits, meaning praise is the habitat of God. Allow him to smell the sweet savor that comes from the praise. He is the one that should judge whether the praise and worship is in spirit and in truth, not you. We can have good musical instrument, good coordination of music, and yet it is in the flesh. People are dancing. Say, why are they dancing? I don't like the way they dance. Are they dancing unto you? Are you their creator? Why are you judging them? And this is you. You have dance, break dance, and disco dance. All kind of charismatic corporal punishment by the devil in where you are unbeliever. And now you are in the church, you stand like an Iroko tree. And you are judging the people dancing. Are they dancing unto you, my brother? I ask you, if they are dancing, all glory must be given to him. They are praising him. Whether they don't know how to dance or they know how to dance, let all go to the Lord that moves God. Somebody say, Professor. Somebody say, Holy Ghost, open my fire. Holy Ghost, open my fire.
I hear a name like Titus Folorunsho. Titus Folorunsho. Titus Folorunsho. Please, if you are here, come out quickly. Come. Bless you, sir. Thank you. Face me. Just face me, please. Face me. Bless you. Brother. You will not cry again.
Amen.
The Lord showed me some witchcraft conspiracy that have been made against this brother. You have moved from one battle to the other battle. Am I communicating? Look at me. Am I communicating? You have moved from one battle to the other battle, yes. From one level to the other. Even now, your life is nothing to write home about.
It's true.
Job. They have stopped you. Things are not just working the way it should be. Am I communicating? Just answer me yes or no. Am I communicating?
Yes, yes, yeah.
I see a lot of things that have happened that sometimes when you sit down and think about them, it affects you.
It's true.
You remember the first woman in your life?
Yes.
You remember what happened?
Yes, sir.
Because there was a witchcraft decree against you, against her, against the children.
Yes.
I saw about 8 women that have held meeting and they have said they will make you cry one after the other. And these women are from your mother place. You know that first woman? She gave birth to the first child. The child died.
It's true.
Am I communicating? I will leave you and go now.
You are communicating.
Is it true?
It's true.
She gave birth to the second one, the child died.
It's true.
She gave birth to the third one, the child died.
It's true.
And she herself, she died.
Yeah,
is it true?
It's true. It's true.
Now, even the parent woman that you marry now,
yes,
they've already strike one of the child that she have for you.
Yes.
That happened by December. Is it true?
It's true. It's true.
Living. When somebody's under tension, it's a shock.
But today God is going to put an end to it.
Amen.
Every arrow of death that have killed your first child, your second child, your third child, today it is over. Stretch forth your hands towards him.
Even you, the way you are not normal. Because they have tied you down. You are not even your senses. Give me the oil. Are you praying for this brother? Pray for him.
I break the arrow of death. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. You arrow of death. I command them to be broken. You shall not die.
Amen.
You shall not die.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Go. You are free. If you are clamping for Jesus, clamp on.